1997, the end of 1997, I was stalked by a gentleman that I had gone out with. I was attacked. I was raped. I was attacked on another separate occasion and got 9 stitches. So you don't feel safe. You don't feel like the police department can keep you safe. And then when you do go, they're so backlogged and they have you in the domestic violence category back then. Ironically, the mind has the ability to perceive trauma and to perceive something that's seemingly awful and destructive for eternity. So you kind of close yourself in and prevent yourself from getting all that support because you're not willing to risk. That creates disease. I pushed through the barriers intentionally. I read books. I read post-traumatic stress disorder books. I did work books. I intentionally healed my mind on that whole aspect of what happened to me. It is trusting yourself and never giving up. It's creating a mindset of positive thinking. Am I going to lay down and cry, or am I going to get up and fight? And it is a fight to get on that path. It doesn't come easy. And I've seen many different faiths. It doesn't have to be one, but you have to have a higher power of some sort. I mean, I used to joke and say, I don't care if you believe in a lampshade. You need to believe in something in your mind and in your soul that is higher than you. Because if you don't have anyone around you, another human being, another soul, where are you gonna go? You don't need a college degree to climb a mountain. You need courage. Being positive is more than just thinking positive. You actually have to train your mind. Every day, it's a training. If you make a mistake, and you communicate verbally to one of the clients negatively, you must restore that little hiccup that you did with 6 positives of reassurance, of affirming, of positive coaching. 6 to 1 negative. My soul and my mind connected because my mind has to kind of give direction. Having conquered cancer twice, stage 4. It wasn't my diet. It was the emotional food, the mind food. What I was feeding in my mind because I had so many challenges. I had been a victim of a crime and it just shattered me. So I knew that my heart had gone through a lot of pressure and stress and I could feel it the second time that I had cancer, that when I had conquered it, I said, if I don't get this right and start focusing on what's up here and in here, this is going to destroy my health. It was like a light and a bell just ringing, going, you've got to get it right this time, lady, because this is your whole life. And so important that you trust this gut instinct. It's something that's, you hear it and you can ignore it and go, no, I've got to stay. You know, I have so many family members that did chemotherapy, but you have to listen to it and you have to trust it. I had family members that thought I was suicidal because I was choosing to say no to chemotherapy and yes to healing therapies. And if a doctor from UCLA has already told me, you're going in 3 months to a year, what have I got to lose to try to get my body healthy first? I cannot believe how rapidly I got well. And I went in February to CMN Hospital in San Luis, and I got well, no symptoms. This is my anniversary month for 5 years. The mind makes the decision in the first place of what you're going to eat. The mind is the first thing that takes action. Where you're going to go? Do I get a blood test? Do I sit here and grieve for 6 weeks? Do I act quickly? It affects the success rate. This is it. Get out of the denial. What do you need to do to fight for your life? How far are you willing to go? We say it in business. The biggest business in the world is fighting for your life.